Alrighty, guys, welcome to week three. Right now, we got the first mock draft, and it looks like we're placed to have the first round, like the first overall pick. And it looks like we would be able to get Bryce Young, and I think that's who I'd go with if I had the first pick. I feel like he would definitely be a nice franchise quarterback for us. I did go with the 2023 draft class. So in week three, we have some re-sign available. Mark Ingram, I will probably wait till the end to see if I want to re-sign him or not. I probably won't. I'm sure I could find another, maybe a little bit younger mentor in free agency if I absolutely need one. But I feel like James Cook might get to a high enough overall where I won't need it, is what I'm hoping anyways. Tavier Thomas, I don't know if I'm going to re-sign him. He's got like no re-sign interest. Rasheem Green has actually a lot of these people. Well, actually, only those two have interest. Everyone else is probably. I'm probably gonna let all these people go and save the cap space, and then try to hope for a good off-season. I think that's what we'll do. So we're checking the trade block real quick. I'm just kind of scrolling through, seeing if there's anything interesting. Baron Browning's on there. Is he? Yeah, he's 26. Kind of curious to see what his trade value is. That's interesting. So I'm kind of just goofing around with trade ideas for like some young players that'll grow. And I'm just gonna try this. Yeah, I didn't think that was gonna go anywhere. I can get them for next year first. I'm just trying to bait on if I should do that or not, just because of. I feel like Kyle Hamilton's gonna be better than any person in next year's draft for in a first round value anyways. And I'd also get a nice young middle linebacker. Just debating on if that's something I wanna do. Because the only trade thing is next year's first and a seventh, which isn't bad. I'm tempted. I'm gonna do it. Alright, so that's four trades. So I have one trade left for the rest of this season until the off season hits. But I feel like getting Kyle Hamilton and Patrick Queen is gonna help out a lot. Just do best lineup. Up to the top. Just wanna rock both the young guys. He had an injury, so I couldn't get rid of him. Alrighty, so we're loading into
From
week
Soldier
three
Field in
game.
Chicago.
Looks like we're away. Hopefully, we just did that new trade for Kyle Hamilton and Patrick Queen. So hopefully
It's the
that'll
first
help
week in
the
Varnum,
passing,
and the
like their
NFL is
passing
in
game
full
a little
swing
bit.
as off we go on EA
Let's hope that
Sports.
makes a
Here's
difference
Dante
because that was a
Pettis on the
first round pick.
return.
I feel like
And
it'll be
up to
worth it.
about the 26-yard
It's
line,
tough to
just
get rid of
across
a
the
first round
25.
pick, but I feel like when you have two young stars like that, I feel like it'll be worth it.
Fields passing on the first play from scrimmage.
There we go. First hit fumbled by Patrick Queen.
Out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Well, obviously you never want to fumble, but if you
we're
going
to have to do QB contain here with Justin Fields. I feel like he's going to want to run a lot.
But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover.
There we go.
If you give up the football,
third and four. Third and three, something like that.
Agree to disagree, I guess.
Can you tell what I played?
Yeah, you played defense. Yeah. I'll let you go.
I took a shot.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. They'll run it. Here's
Montgomery. There we go.
And he will lose yardage here to the
31-yard line. Patrick Queen already off to a huge start here.
They're ahead of schedule after the gain of 7 on first down.
A forced fumble and
a
tackle for a loss in the first drive.
On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Yeah, last week in the loss,
seems like our first drive is usually like our best drive on defense. I think it said we had the number 2 ranked defense. Which is that's probably only because of the yardage, and we just throw a bunch of interceptions so they don't go far.
The Texans for their opening drive. Leading them out, the 26 overall pick for
the
2020 draft.
We're on all Madden, so it's going to be a little tough with low overall quarterbacks. That was a bad run.
And he'll be tackled.
That could have gotten a little bit further.
The numbers a week ago for Cook. 14 carries, 77 yards.
I can't remember the last time we did a game and a coach didn't talk about establishing the run first, but they've lost 2 straight games, so they still want to do that, but they've got to have some contingencies, some other options.
I really hope that was something with the defense.
To open up things and maybe run it a little bit more later in the game.
All right, let us have second down back.
Titus
Thank
Howard,
you.
Right tackle, the man flagged for that one.
All right, let's try this.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Love from the gun.
There we go.
Got his man. It's Bo Melton. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a
Sorry, James Cook's got the first down right here. We're going to switch this to the left side. He is...
They'll run it. Here's Cook.
I don't know why.
First down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard
I feel like this play action's going
to
haunt us, but we're going
to
give it a shot.
And listen,
sometimes it works, sometimes it don't.
First 2 games, CD, but yeah, talking with him in the days leading up to this one, doesn't seem like they've lost any confidence.
I would agree. Guys on the team and in the locker room, but they do have to start winning some games.
On second down, Cook.
Running game starting off good.
The 45 to the 47. They get 6 and 4. Leave them with 3rd and 4.
It's tough. I don't know. I think, yeah, James Cook's tired, so I'm glad I'm not running it here. I might put that just on a slant so I hit that for a first down.
They tipped it. Excellent coverage there on 3rd down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
We're at my 40. I think I'm going to go for this. I feel like we're having a good drive. I feel like we can get it.
He couldn't hang on to the pass.
Spin him out wide and maybe hit Bo Melton here.
For it on fourth.
Damn, okay.
It's
okay. I feel like it's an okay spot to have gone for that.
Doesn't pan out, and it'll be a turnover.
Put QB spy on. I feel like they're about to run it here.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery.
Totally just missed the head stick.
Play to the 37. The numbers on the ground for Montgomery in last week's
So it seems that they run a good little bit.
91 yards.
They had 40 rushes in the last 2 games, so they're running about 20 a game.
Do they decide to bring that down a little bit and try and keep him fresh? Or do they say, guess what? He's locked in. Keep handing him the football.
And he is going to lose yardage here.
Nice play, nice play.
This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher 3rd down looming. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Fields on 3rd down. And unable to connect.
Ooh, I got lucky there.
Caught it,
good
it would
defense.
Have been a first down. Instead, it's 4th.
There we go. They missed it.
And he missed it. It's no good, and this will remain a scoreless game.
I feel like going for it was a good idea because, I mean, I trusted my defense a little bit.
The Texans
and
offense,
I felt like our offense was rolling a little bit. We just hit a little dry spell, so hopefully this drive can kind of shake out of it a little bit.
The offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense came through and was able to hold them without
any
points.
I think this could get a first down right here.
Break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us.
There we go. Oh, I thought he was going to spin around that.
We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively.
James Cook is tired again.
Fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so, but maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
And now a throw on first
down. I thought
that was about
to be intercepted.
The big story all week: Texans coach Lovie Smith making his return to Chicago. Lovie, of course, the coach of the Bears from 04 to 2012, and he was at the helm when the Bears won that NFC title in 2006.
All right, that's the end of the first quarter.
In the Windy City. Then he would have that pit stop down in Tampa and then come back to the state of Illinois as the head coach of the Fighting Illini in the Big Ten.
Let's try this.
Before returning to the National Football
Hopefully
League.
I got to hit Cook in
so
the middle.
Third down now. They need the 27-yard
Seth
line
Williams on a slant here. And see what the middle linebacker bites on. Wow, they read that one. I'm glad that was overthrown.
Like what I see so far out of this defense because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts.
I think that's in.
Their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
Let's go.
Blankenship's
on the board.
Good. And it's now 3-0 Texans.
I got a decent kicker and punter in free agency,
like
so
this,
I'm pretty happy about that.
I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. To Montgomery to begin the drive.
There we go.
And this one goes
Patrick
nowhere.
Queen is
losing yardage
falling
back in the 22. Stopped in his
I think he's a huge piece. I feel like
Patrick
this trade
Queen.
Was totally worth it.
To start the drive.
I mean, it's going to be an all-season thing to find out, but...
Back to throw, Fields. He's got a man here, it's Montgomery.
There we go.
Finding room at midfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Fields. And now a loose football. The ball comes
there
out.
There we go.
The Texans scoop it.
Nice play landing, Collins.
Set up shop at the 33-yard
I think he had the forced fumble and the recovery there.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
All right, no turnovers.
They start the drive with Cook.
There
and
we go, nice
right
run.
On the chalk of the 45. 52 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Okay, let's see. Switch this up here. Let's try this.
Play fake. Here's Love.
A
quick throw.
Oh, they swatted
away. It's incomplete.
Jeez,
that's
one
a nice
for
job
seven.
There because you've got to play the ball, not the
We've
man
had six
incompletions
in
a
row.
From a lot of needless penalties, and he's able
I'm
to
sure to
that
hit
one away.
James Cook here on the outside.
On play
I think
action.
He's
going to
be open down low. Oops,
R1.
Away.
And incomplete
Good
on
defense.
The
Good defense.
Like to do. He pushed it down
I don't know what to go run. Here.
But I think that since he was outside the pocket and there was open
I feel like
space,
this usually works sometimes, but it's
game.
Hit or miss.
The Texans on third down.
It really depends on if they're doing man
far.
Or zone.
This is third and 10. Forced out to
that was horrible. All right, we got a punt. That was bad. At least there's no interception. I'd rather punt than have an interception.
And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bears take
Huge
over.
Huge hit.
The Bears offense ready to go.
I want to say that was Kyle Hamilton, too.
Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points
nice
category,
play.
But in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better
Let's
here
Let's go defense.
Drive.
Let's get another stop here. I don't think we'll get a three and out, but I feel like we could definitely hold them to punt again.
From the 24, Fields.
There we
and
go.
He can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
Mario Edwards.
Mario Edwards. Edwards flies in to blow that play up. They'll be in search of 8 yards.
All right, I'm
going to
watch
to convert the first
that.
Down.
I feel like he's about to do a curl.
Throwing nope, on third outside. Down, Fields. And that'll be caught by St. Brown.
I think that's
and
fourth. Oh, they
the
just
Bears
got it.
First down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Okay. I'm going to send a blitz in real quick.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our
score.
Let me
see what they're running.
We remind you that coming up at halftime,
okay.
We'll take you to
they're
Orlando
passing.
And Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes,
there we
do.
Go.
The Bears moving hastily in their hurry-up offense. Fields hit and the ball is loose.
Queen again with a forced fumble.
And his guys are gonna get the football.
I don't know what kind of animation on the camera they had there, but
line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They got the fumble recovery. Now here's Love to pass.
Oh, that was a dart. Good throw, Love. That was just good defense.
Second down. So after the incompletion on first,
all right, I might try hitting Shakir here up over the top.
Love looking to throw it. He's gonna fire
yep.
this thing deep
yep.
right sideline. And
let's go.
Man, it's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Khalil Shakir with his first career NFL touchdown.
That's huge.
And the
that's
Texans
huge.
Are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. It's Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now.
There we
trailing.
Go.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string
hey,
a few completions together, reach the end zone, and they make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
A first and 10 here. Good. You know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
We're about a minute in from
yeah,
halftime.
Pretty well because they were trying to leak the tight
I feel like if we could
the
hold them
flat,
here, that's
a
good start for
the
half.
The first down.
Be a nice
Fields
first half
again.
If I can hold them here.
Got an open man. It's Pringle. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10 from the gun. Here's Fields. Escaping.
There we go. Patrick Queen with the sack.
He's taken down.
A huge game for
Patrick
Queen here.
Got in there to stick him. He gets the sack. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17.
Oh, I totally messed that
Montgomery.
Up.
And he'll be marked down at about the
10 seconds.
Line.
I think they're going to go for it and then try to go for the field goal.
To go before halftime.
Oh, no. I
so
went for just
on third
field
down,
goal.
The field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get three before half. This a 43-yard attempt. And now they'll take
try
a timeout defensively.
It.
After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter.
All right, they made this one.
And through, and
so it looks like it's
going to
be 10-3 going into half.
The Texans offense ready to
watch
go
Shakir
here for
here,
their next drive.
I think I'm just going to commit to the run.
Their defense has done the job. Now
yep.
it's the offense's
run.
Turn as they've got it first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Man, I just love
right.
being in this stadium.
We're
so much history,
left this time and see what
so
happens.
Many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right
there
now.
There we go, first down.
Contested in the third quarter.
James Cook is having
Texans
a huge game.
First down as he's able to get this up past the 40. To throw now. Here's Love.
Oh, that was so close to being intercepted.
And incomplete.
He's smart enough to avoid the taunting.
The passing game
is
not working right now.
He has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
They're going to hurry back to the line now.
I'm going to try this comeback route.
They go bootleg. Love. They'll roll him out right. Completes to Shakir.
Shakir's having a big game.
And he's going to have another first touchdown as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 24-yard line.
All right, let's try running up the middle here. See if we can get a nice little 5-yard gain. I'll be happy.
A 10th carry in the game for Cook.
There's a 10-yard.
A great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and they'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. Inside 4 minutes to go. Third quarter.
I don't want to throw an interception.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. A quick throw
that was close.
Batted away and incomplete.
But based on the play we just saw there, he might not be the guy you want to challenge.
I feel like if they hit to a head stick on Cook, he's going to fumble because he's a little tired here.
And he'll get
I try to be a truck just so they wouldn't get a head stick in animation.
There, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine.
Actually, let's run with, actually, no, we need to pass it here, third and seven.
Was uncanny.
And that's exactly
will just run
what
it,
you want from your
see what happens.
Back to the ground, this time with Ingram. Well, this is
fourth and one. Let's run it again.
It's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so
I feel like
short.
I can get it first down here. There we go.
And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have
let's
the
go.
First down as he's tackled at the two. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But
let's
by
see
about
if
the
Cook's
width
back
of
out.
Shoelace,
yes, okay. Let's see if we get a
down.
Rushing touchdown here with Cook for his first of the year.
Cook.
There it is.
Take this one in for a Texans touchdown.
All righty, we're looking way better this game.
Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed
we're,
to give a
we've
little
gotten lucky
cushion.
With a couple missed interceptions, but
you talk about them commanding
our defense is
keeping
locked
the fight
down.
Where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring.
Here we go.
Some good games coming up here in
let's
week
see
three, the first weekend of fall
what will happen. We're already on QB contain
from Denver.
For this man coverage play.
Fans are probably saying,
I might just try to blitz
Russell
with
Wilson.
Queen.
Now they'll see
depending
tonight.
On what gap is open. Yep.
On Monday night, Cowboys and Giants from MetLife Stadium kicking off at 8:15 Eastern. And he's going to lose yardage here. That one unable to
right.
develop, never got going. A loss
we're
of a couple.
On this. I'm
going to
go with Bernard here.
Looky there, Charles.
Kind of guard the middle.
Already making an impact on the defensive side of the football.
Maybe not a superstar, but he does a few things well, and I think they'll emphasize that in his new role with
go.
This team.
There we go.
And this one incomplete.
Third and 12. Here we
too
go.
Much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Fields. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to have to
another sack.
Down he goes.
Patrick Queen's going to have player of the week.
Picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Here's Brett Kern now.
I feel like both
as
of our picks have had a good game already. I feel like I think Kyle Hamilton only has a couple tackles, but he does have a tackle for a loss. And Queen's just had an amazing game for his first week here.
Come up to start all right, the next
and swim with Ingram
yeah,
here.
That's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey
he just got tripped up. That's nice.
That's a flag coming out every time.
Okay, let's do
so
a
to contend with second and 13
power
after the first
O here and see what happens.
Backwards.
I feel like John Ross
Love.
Could burn him.
They go play action now. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw deep right side.
That was very close.
That would be incomplete. Try to dial up the long
all right, let's,
way out there.
I like this play.
Down.
Let's try to hit it with John Ross.
Last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And it's going to be incomplete.
Yeah, I don't think he got his feet down. Right, let's just go to instant replay real quick and just check this out. Yeah, he definitely didn't get his feet down.
Alrighty,
let's punt it then.
And it's going to bring up fourth down. The Texans send the punter out as he'll punt it away for the second time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well.
Another huge hit for Kyle Hamilton
on the
punt.
On the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered.
I feel like one of these times he's going
to
have a forced fumble.
As they take over. The Bears offense ready
get
to go
a little bit
for
quicker.
Their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's
honestly,
a pass first
I don't think
league,
that was a bad read. I went in the right
surprising.
Gap, and I forced him outside.
Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
It'll be dropped
nice play, Brady Breeze.
Six across the 30 to the 31.
All right, so we're entering the fourth quarter, and we have a 14-point lead.
After this, this is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. We'll get that to Amir Smith-Marset, and he will have the first down here.
Sorry.
He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Out of the gun, Fields. Now he's forced.
There we go.
He can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Terrell Bernard in there to drop him, and that will go in the
They're
books.
Definitely pass. I think they're going to have some type of crossing out here.
Career. Congratulations, young man. Flush to his right.
Ooh, I was hoping he'd stay up for one more second.
The first down.
I should have knew that one was coming.
There, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10.
We contain on.
Fields leaving it with Montgomery here on the option.
Nice D.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery.
I don't know what
and
just happened.
Carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and 4. A shotgun snap. Fields. He'll leave it for Montgomery complete.
Tackle the man for the first down.
The Bears first down. Although it doesn't appear to be by much. He needed 4. He got 4 on third down. Here's Fields. Finds
I totally just missed
slant.
That. And missed that dive.
20, and he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
All right, let's see. What, I think they're going to.
Fields
oh,
tapping
never mind.
It forward, jet sweep. And he is
there we go.
Lose yardage here.
That's huge.
So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back.
Alrighty.
Let's see what they've come up with.
Gotta watch Cole Kmet here. I think he's gonna do
a,
like a 6 yard curl.
Second and 13.
Nope.
Fields. This one swung
there
out
we
to
go.
Montgomery.
Alright, third and 8 inside the 10.
To the 10-yard line.
As long as we don't
he'll
allow a touchdown here, they're probably gonna have to go for
down.
A field goal. And I spoke
this
too soon. Good
so
play, good play.
Everything here. This one's not over yet.
All right, so there's a minute and
a
half
nice
left
throw there
in
by
the
second-year
fourth.
Quarterback. And I don't believe that's
I
the
think
kind
they
of
might go for an
rookie.
Onside kick.
Because usually your rookie season
I don't know.
Is
I don't know what their
of your college
logic
days.
With
a lot of
this time left is. I think
it,
they're
going
to go for an onside kick. So.
Now he's settled in the pocket a little
oh, wow,
bit
okay.
more. Reading the field and getting
kick.
To a second and sometimes third
okay.
progression.
Set
that
it.
Was a nice
bounce
play.
Off the end zone.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Alrighty, let's just try to burn some clock here and not have any turnovers.
Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has 3 timeouts.
There we go.
This is a very
nice
slim
run.
Lead they're holding on to. And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done.
I feel like James Cook is coming up
game.
To 100 yards.
Line, your tight end, your receivers.
I think he's like 70, 80 maybe.
Don't let there be penetration because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the
if
clock.
If they quit calling timeouts, I might actually be able to
but
see how many yards he has.
If you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might
all
be
right.
able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete.
Inside zone.
The run got
we have 103
forward.
Rushing yards, so it's
six.
Pretty much mainly him.
They'll try and wind down some clock with Cook.
There we go.
Now the Bears will use
looks like that's all their timeouts.
Timeout,
so if we can get a first down here, that's
game.
Pretty much it.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third
protect.
Down. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's
there
Cook.
We go. First
and
down.
Have the first down and that is suck the
yeah, I really
right
feel like a
ground.
Lot of times with James Cook, if
not
you give
totally
him 20 carries,
yet,
he's putting up 100 yards.
They come up first and 10. And he'll get this down only to about the 46.
There we go, though. That's just that first down last play sealed it.
So second and nine, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line.
So we just got to pretty much let the time run down.
The Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was it.
Alrighty, guys, that is it. Looks like we got our first win on the season, and we're now 1-2.
They get the late score, they get the victory, and
that trade right there definitely helped us out a lot. I feel like that.
And Brandon, just like you,
Patrick Queen's performance is what pretty much got us to win there. So
when they were mounting that game-winning drive,
I'll take it. Jordan Love
shied away from it.
Didn't do the best this week, but James Cook definitely carried us on offense with 18 carries and 111 yards, and I think he had only one touchdown. So, alrighty, so we have some player upgrades. I will probably do a couple of these. I will definitely do Patrick Queen's. I'll probably give him Field General. I didn't even realize he's a star. Does he have any tags? No tags. And let's see. Can we see? Actually, it's going to be in here. Oh, I guess not. Wanted to see if there's any way I could see how much is on his contract right here. I'm going to have to do it in roster. For Petrie, let's give him hybrid. And then these two, I'll just auto. Alrighty, guys. So we got the win in week 3. We're now 1-2. I'll see you guys in week 4. And definitely let me know what team I should relocate to, because that is definitely coming up. Have a good one.